What was going on in my head when I first had the idea to write this, man?
It was something that was there. It was this fire, I guess, I had in me, which I was just going, whew. I had this thought in my head, and I was trying to think of what else could this song be? Could it be anything else? Just bubbling up, those things happened. It was right around November, December, January of 2017. You know, everybody knows what that was like. There's all these things in the news and shootings going on with police. And, you know, I grew up black in Texas, man. It's kind of fucked up, you know? Getting like dog shit in the mailbox, people writing nigger on my fence outside my house, at my parents' house, you know? You know, riding around their trucks, Confederate flags over my fence and shit. You know, this was a regular occurrence. It was anger. I'm still angry, you know? I had a situation. I said I wasn't gonna get into this because it makes me emotional, you know? But, you know, I had a situation with my neighbor. I got some property, I'm doing all right. Young, successful black man. Go get myself some property and live the life that I never had, something that I always wanted. You're not gonna give us 40 acres and a mule, I'm gonna get 50 acres and a fucking classic Model A that I earned. So when my neighbor comes to me and says, who owns this house, who lives here? I do. There's no way you can live here. Who's the owner? I live here. Maybe it wasn't racial, but in my mind, I was thinking that, you know? And I'm tired of thinking that. I'm tired of us having to think that way. I was in Memphis recently. And every time I'm in Memphis, I go to the Lorraine Hotel. They turn it into a museum since the last time I saw it. So I walked in. The first room you go into, you hear these sounds. You hear water. And you hear moans, you hear chains, and you hear screams. And my people have been through a lot, and I haven't been through shit compared to them. So if I can do anything with my opportunity and the work that they put in, the least I can do is say, thank you for your sacrifice. Thank you, Dr. Martin Luther King, for sacrificing your life so I can get up and have a microphone. I'm not taking this for granted. Thank you. We've come too far, so to see this in the news and to go backwards, I'm not going backwards. We're not going backwards. Fuck you, we're here. We're all here. There's nothing you can do about it. We all have to live next to each other. There's nowhere we can go. We are here.
Back where you come from. You don't want me to want your kind. lights up. No, I can't stop grinding. No, I can't let them bring me. No, I can't let them find me. Or you can meet my friend the governor, only if you wanna try me. Or you can meet my other friend the judge, just in case you think I'm lying. And I know you think I'm up to something. I'm just eating, I was still hungry. And this is mine, I legit, I ain't leaving it. You can't take it from me. I remember when they used to tell me, nigga run, go back where.